Thanksgiving week has come and gone, and with it has come some serious shakeups around the league. I'm joined by our NFL experts, Ellie Whittington and Drew Gentry, to discuss the playoff picture heading into the final quarter of the season. So, Drew, the Saints have had an 8-game winning streak that just got snapped by the Rams, and Alvin Kamara is arguably in the running now for Rookie of the Year, but they've struggled with stronger opponents. Are the Saints legit?
I do not think they are legit. I think they might get into the playoffs as a wild card because I think Atlanta might overtake them.
Or the Panthers.
Or the Panthers, but I didn't really think of the Panthers that much.
Okay.
The Saints have only won against teams with winning records right now 3 times this season and have lost to all 3 other opponents that are above
They lost to the Patriots and the Vikings, which are very good teams.
Yes.
I want to point out a stat. So they're the third team that has started the season 0-2. There's only been 3 other teams that have started the season 0-2 and won a 6-game winning streak. That was the 93 Cowboys and the 07 Giants. Both of those teams went on to win the Super Bowl. So there's a statistic for you. Of the 3 teams, those teams went on to win the Super Bowl. So I believe the Saints are going to win the Super Bowl? No. So I believe that they have a good shot. Look at the statistics. 6-game winning streak, and they only lost to 2 incredible teams.
Okay, but they've also lost to the Rams. Yes, the Rams are also incredible at 8-3. But they barely squeaked by the Redskins, and the Redskins are 5-6 at this point in the season, and they had to rely on a miracle by Drew Brees to come back from 15 down with under 3 minutes to play.
Let's talk about Drew Brees. He's a very veteran quarterback, and I think he does not get the credit that he deserves. Yeah. He's been in the league for so long. He can carry this team. Just like I think Tom Brady gets all the praise because he wins Super Bowls. Drew Brees is also such a good quarterback.
And
when you have a leader of this team that can lead these Saints, now the NFC South is a very competitive division right now.
Yeah, very
and
true.
I don't know if the Saints but will win this division. I think it's very competitive, but you cannot say that a team that is playing this well does not have a shot at the playoffs.
I say they have a shot at the playoffs. I just told you they're going to be a 6. The question was, are they NFL, like, Super Bowl contenders?
Well, how can you say a team that's number one in their division is not a Super Bowl contender?
Very true. But I just don't see them lasting through the playoffs because that is, like, one of those times where you do step up and show up. And Drew Brees has proved that he's a good quarterback. He's won a Super Bowl. He brought one to New Orleans.
And I didn't say that they're going to win this Super Bowl. I just said they have a good shot.
Yeah. Well, coming from another team in the NFC South,
okay.
The rocky start for the Falcons is now gone because now they're 7-4 and they're sitting 1 game back in the division. Ellie, are they a threat and on the hunt for the playoff spot?
No. I truly believe in this Super Bowl curse the year after you lose in the Super Bowl, which was devastating for the Falcons, that you just aren't going to play. You're not going to have that chance to win again. Now, the Falcons are playing well, and they're proving themselves, and I can agree with that, but they lost to the Dolphins. If you lose to the Dolphins, I don't have a lot of hope for you. They lost to the Bills. The Bills are playing okay. And they lost to the Patriots, which I understandable. But the Dolphins?
Yeah.
You're not going to win a Super Bowl if you can't beat the Dolphins.
Somebody loses to the Browns every year. So
the Browns haven't won a game this year.
I know, but the Dolphins are 4-7. And the Saints beat them, so I understand where you're coming from, that the Falcons aren't probably as legit. But I think they are. I think Julio Jones is back after having 253 yards last game and scoring twice, which is he's only scored 3 times this season. But you saw Sanu throw that touchdown pass to him, showing the versatile offense of them. And they're on 3 straight victories, like we said.
But you're giving me one player. Julio Jones cannot carry the Falcons.
But Matt Ryan, I think, can step his game up like he did last year.
He can, but will he?
Who knows? But they're only 1 game behind the Panthers and the Saints right now, and they have the Saints twice, and they have the Panthers 1 more time. So they have a chance to possibly sneak up, win that division. And right now they're still placed at the 6th seed, so you could still see them in the playoffs as a wild card or as the.
The Saints and the Panthers, who are both fighting so hard. I mean, this NFC South is a very – I'm loving this competition that's going on right now, especially going into the end of the season. Are the Falcons playing well? Yes, I'll give you that. Are they playing better than we expected? Yes. Are they going to go far? No.
Well, now, from an early favorite, the Kansas City Chiefs, everyone thought that they were going to make it to the Super Bowl, but now that they've lost the last 5 of 6 games – we know now to never pick favorites early. Drew, is it a better idea to pick your contenders now? Who do you have in the Super Bowl?
Hey, my Super Bowl pick is going to be the Battle for Pennsylvania. It's the Eagles versus the Steelers. So the Eagles are the number one team in the league right now, sitting at 10-1. Their last loss was to the Red Hot Chiefs, who started off 5-0. Okay, so when you see that, you're like, okay, that's a reasonable loss at that time in the season. But then they're first in points per game, second in rushing yards per game, and third in total yards. They have one of the best offenses, or they have this like best offense in the league. and they're proving themselves week in and week out, and their past three straight victories have been by 28
yeah,
points.
Yeah, I agree. The Eagles are a great contender right now, but I'm not going with them for the Super Bowl. Philadelphia has this wonderful fan base, and you just threw a bunch of stats at me that you can read a stat sheet to me all day, but I don't think that means that you're going to pick the Super Bowl. So I am going with the Patriots, led by Tom Brady, and the Minnesota Vikings, which is very different than you picked, but I think that the Vikings are just, as you were explaining about the Falcons, are just on such a hot streak right now. Case Keenum is just really leading this team, which no one expected to have this quarterback. And I will tell you exactly why I think the Vikings are going to make it to the Super Bowl is because if they could make it to the Super Bowl, they'd be playing at home. There has never been a team to play at home in the Super Bowl. And I think that sitting in the Vikings, like, just like going forward, like, how could you not want to do that?
Everybody thought the Cowboys were going to do that a few years ago, and I'm pretty sure they went 4-12 the year they were hosting the Super Bowl.
Well, that they're not 4-12.
All right, but also, Wentz has playoff experience, not in the NFL, but he has 5 straight national championships in college, which is college, but it's FCS, which is one of the hardest ways to win a national championship, and was the MVP twice.
Okay, you're also talking about someone that has been in the league for very little time, and I'm talking about Tom Brady, who has several Super Bowl rings, and I think that you doubt any Patriots that you are, like, you cannot, this team, you know, they've had a really kind of a rough year, but I think anyone to doubt the Patriots, somebody that won't even eat strawberries and drink alcohol.
Exactly.
Yeah, and they can, he eats avocados and does, I think that Tom Brady has this superpower thing that you can never say that the Patriots, I don't care, they haven't won a game, that they're still going to be contenders and they'll come out of somewhere.
Well, the Patriots are definitely a reliable team and Carson Wentz looking to prove himself, but that's all the time we have here for us on One-on-One Sports. Be sure to check us out on all of our social media platforms, and for all of us here at the studio, whose side are you on?